whom does Atrel Academy address? So it could be a student, I have students coming from 6th standard onwards. Some are there from 10th, 12th, college, even some teachers, and we are also associated with industry personnel. The interesting thing is, like, there are many people who may be in commerce, who may be in some other field, who have an inclination to do some science, maybe as a hobby. Like recently I happened to meet one person in sales tax. He happened to visit our office. He was saying, okay, I need an environment where, like, I can have the tools, I have the miscellaneous things where I can try it out with a little bit of guidance. Though I'm in commerce, this has been childhood dream. So when he saw this, he immediately said, I want to come in as a student. So this is the environment which we want to provide. Say, when we offer the basic sessions, anybody should be able to attend the class. It's not that if I do some physics class, which is only a 10th student who has to come. In fact, we want across age groups, whomsoever is interested in learning, maybe they have missed some classes earlier, or like they are in industry, or they are in totally a different domain, they just want to understand, except Atrel Academy will provide a space for them. This is one perspective is from the learning aspect. Second thing is, we want to support grassroots innovators. Generally, what is available today is, like, we have angel investors, venture capitals, all that. So all that requires, or like, it all begins with an idea. The objective of Atrel Academy is, there are so many people available around with basic commitment. All that they are saying is, I am willing to work, so what should I do? So we would like to start from that place itself. We provide space, we provide the necessary tools, we have a Wi-Fi connected, and we can provide the sufficient network, and we help them to learn and even incubate an idea. So after the idea, we support them up till it goes to commercialization. In fact, as part of our team, we have an advocate, we have a strategic business consultant who will help the people with business plans. And we have a supporter in terms of web hosting, where we provide them free web hosting. So once the business gets successful, then we will go for a payment. So until then, all this we are doing it as an environment where research, entrepreneurship and education can flourish. And even in education, we should say thanks to Annalakshmi, which is a hotel in Coimbatore. It's a very, very unique model where they don't charge upfront. There is no billing, there is no price tag. You go eat, and when you come back, you pay whatever you feel like paying. So this is something which we want to adopt in Atrel as well, because when we buy a product, you have a choice to return. Like you buy online or you go to a shop, like you have a opportunity to return and get the money back. But in education, that doesn't work, because it's absolutely intangible. Students spend their time, a teacher spends their time, but end of the day, it was not fruitful for either of us. The money exchange is lost. So we don't want to do that. So we want to engage, give them an experience. If they are happy with us, then they come in. Another aspect which we want to highlight here is, in the current education system, there is an absolute lock-in for the students. Let's say a student registered for a arts or a engineering program, like they are locked to a single educational institution. So they cannot go out, whatever is the given situation, after paying all the money. So here we don't want to give that. There is open source tools, learning tools available today. There is distance learning, NPTEL courses are there. You have national open schooling even at the school level. So at the leisure, at their independence, they can schedule themselves and learn. So this is a platform or an environment which we want to provide at Atrel Academy. One more aspect is, in current education systems, students go through 5 or 6 subjects in a day every 1 hour. Whether they have caught up with the earlier topic or not, that is not given. So they are kept on dumping with information. So here what we do is, we try to understand the student first. What is that they are lagging? What is that they are looking for? What are their strengths? Say, for example, I had a student coming in She was absolutely frank. She said, I don't want any tuitions. I have some doubts. You clarify, that much is sufficient. So we have students like that. So this is the environment. Say, few people want handholding, few people want to have only doubts clarification. Some of them would not have had hands-on experience, so they should come here and play with it. And another opportunity for people who come here is they have a chance to sit and observe what others are doing, because we take industry projects as well. So even a 10th standard student currently, let's say, like, he doesn't know where any of what is studying is being applied, but this gives them a platform. They interact with the people and they know where these things are used, so that gives them the motivation. So this is something which Nautical Academy provides. So from education, we want to make education a fun. In fact, it is a fun environment. We have something called as the industry word used is called gamification. We make it a real